All right. Welcome everyone on the stage. I have on my right Mr. Rajagopal from Business Development Race Future. On my left is Madam Geetha, already introduced to you. And I also have Mr. Niranjan Naik, National Sales Head from Bosch. And hopefully Mr. Narsimhan would be joining us back on the stage. So I'll first give an opportunity to all the panel members to introduce themselves and maybe just give a short speech of 5 minutes on what they think is the broader and general situation when it comes to solar power in Tamil Nadu. So I'll start with Madam Geetha first.
I'm Geetha, Director of Projects. Good morning to all participants. We in Tamil Nadu are the pioneers in promoting renewable energy. Right from 1986, I think we were the first one to install windmills in Tamil Nadu. And with the conducive policies of the government, more private players joined. And today, more than 8,000 megawatts of wind energy is through private players. The solar also, I think we were the first one under a central government scheme, right in 2010 itself, with 5 megawatt highest capacity those days was installed in Tamil Nadu. 2012, there was a policy by the government to go and install 3,000 megawatts of solar. Today, we have installed so far, it is 1,865 megawatts. And by another 2 years, we'll be crossing 5,000 megawatts. So overall, in India, we are number one in wind generation, maybe number three in solar. And the world map also, we have a place. We hold a ninth place in overall renewable generation. Our installed capacity in Tamil Nadu is 29,000 megawatt, including renewables. We are power surplus today. Right from 2015, we continue to be surplus, and in future also we'll be surplus. So towards this solar thing, we have now in Kadaladi, we are coming up with a solar power plant, 500 megawatt capacity in a single location. And soon we'll be coming out with tenders calling for EPC contractors who will do it for us. With all this, I think our solar capacity is bound to cross 5,000 megawatts in the near future. I welcome everyone to this thing, and I wish this grand success. Let us discuss.
Okay, good morning, ladies and gentlemen. I'm Niranjan. I work with Bosch. Just a brief introduction about Bosch. Bosch is a German company based out of Stuttgart, which is almost about 130 years old. In India, we are there from 1951 onwards, headquartered at Bangalore. We have almost about 30,000 people working in the country with a turnover of about 18,000 crores. Bosch Energy and Building Solutions, which is a part of the Bosch overall group in India. We are a pretty small division with about 350 crores. We have close to about 100 megawatts of projects which we have installed. We are primarily focused on both ground-mounted as well as rooftop projects across the country. Very, very focused on the rooftop segment. And we have significant number of projects what we are doing in Tamil Nadu as well. So I congratulate Madam on being, I recently read that almost about 50% of the renewables, of the energy generated is from the renewables in Tamil Nadu, which is really excellent. We are here in, we have a lot of projects which Bosch is also working in Tamil Nadu on, and hopefully we are looking at closing things in the 2018. Thank you.
Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. Thanks for the opportunity. I am Rajagopal from Race Power. We are mainly into utility scale projects, and of course, we have entered into the rooftop segment as well quite recently through Race Future Energy. We are present all over India and we are expanding our business overseas as well. We are based out of Delhi. We have branches in Hyderabad, Bangalore, Chennai. We are opening quite soon. And of course, in North, we are strongly present. We have signed 100 megawatts power PPA with the Tamil Nadu government, and we would be starting the project soon. Now, the so far as the this one is concerned, policy is concerned, you know, Tamil Nadu is quite, advanced, as we know, as we all know well. But I believe that, you know, we need to be much more competitive with our neighboring states. It should be a healthy competition, and I believe that our neighboring states have a much more progressive policy. So I think we need to learn the best practices and then progress our state in renewable energy much more faster. So I believe that we need to take the steps to compete with AP primarily, to attract large scale investments in renewable energy. So the audience is also welcome at the end of the discussions to share their views, share the strategies, what they can give to us as IPP, and then to the government as well. So let us look forward to a healthy and interesting debate. Thank you.
So Mr. Narsimhan has already shared his viewpoint in a very energetic and passionate speech earlier. Sir, if you would like to add more to the broader scene in Tamil Nadu as far as the solar is concerned and how you see it going forward.
As I earlier mentioned in various forums and today also, Tamil Nadu is one of the main hub, but it is having the natural assets for exploiting for the solar energy. The government policies are also very good, but we people face some kind of issues in the implementation. And our madam is here regarding Tangetco. As I requested, please take care of the payment part. Everybody is looking for that. Otherwise, Tamil Nadu is the best in the country. Even in the recent past, the tenders has been finalized at the rate of 3.47. When my company 3.47, we have become a L1 in out of 1,500 megawatts. The next moment, hundreds of calls I could receive from various corporate sector and big solar energy companies scolding me, saying that what made you go for a 3.47. I said, understand the situation. What is the vision of India? The government is trying to go for the low cost energy, and the tariff has to be balanced. We cannot go more than a reasonable tariff. Already there was some kind of indications that Rewa and Badla Park people quoted at 2.44, 2.46. Again, these people contested with me, sir, there is a payment, there is a security, it is a park. I said, still here you are going to get one more rupee. With that rupee, all we know, Tamil Nadu pays 3.47, Rajasthan pays 2.48. People went and got it there. This difference, even as a commercial mentality oriented people, they can calculate very well. This kind of risk in Tamil Nadu, a small risk in the payment, can be bypassed, can be inbuilt with a little bit higher tariff than when you compare the other states. As I mentioned in the previous talk, yes, all these struggles are getting over. I believe with the support of the government of India, Tamil Nadu, Tangetco can come over the payment problems. This is one part. I had a bitter experience in Tamil Nadu. Today, I got a better experience in Tamil Nadu. I hope for the best experience in the upcoming period, where all you can trust and enjoy. The current government here, with the support of the central government guidance, definitely will achieve the target of earlier Madam Amma, at least to reach 5,000 to 8,000. The target is there for Tamil Nadu government to go for 8,000 megawatt. This could have been achieved by this time. Unfortunately, because of earlier disturbances in politics, got delayed. Once again, I request Bosch or any of the companies are here, kindly look forward to set up some plants in Tamil Nadu. We Indian Solar Association, as individual and as well as the chairman of this organization, we can support you in the acquisition of the land, and support of Tangedco can be ensured. My only worry is today in the country for the solar energy, there are some threats. Some of the wrong guidance by some of the consultants given to Government of India, you should impose 70% of the safeguard duty and anti-dumping. This kind of threats we are trying to remove. Unless until you have a mega manufacturing sector, you can't go for this kind of impacts. People, those who signed a PPA at these low rates, they can't tolerate, and where they will going to collapse. For example, SoftBank, they got the energy sector by name SB Energy, all you know. They are also our members. So they went and argued with the government. Suddenly, if you go on imposing the safeguard duty or anti-dumping duty or various reasons, we cannot accept or we cannot do the project. The investor will get a lot of confusions, and the funding institutions will face some kind of problems. So we represented finally with the Arun Jaitley, the finance minister, to remove this confusion, to invite the investment across the globe and go for the low-cost funding in India itself. This is one part. Other part, coming to the manufacturing sector, before you are asking so many questions, I want to clarify. This country today, under 100 megawatt scheme, under gigawatt of our Prime Minister vision, we could able to reach in these three and a half years of our NDA government comes to power, only 20 gigawatts. Minister is not here, so I can talk freely. 20 gigawatts we reach, that's all. Our talk is for 100 gigawatt. If you count 20 gigawatt for 3 years, for 100 gigawatt, how many years we need to go? This one side. But the time frame given by Government of India, this vision should be reached by 2022. How it is possible? One side you are planning to put the import duty, another side safeguard duty, another side anti-dumping, another side, I know how the people are crying, 3,000 containers of solar panels imported from various countries has been stalled across the various ports in this country because the wrong quote by Customs Department. When we interacted with the finance minister or the commerce minister, they are not coming forward to accept or reject. I represented all the levels to eliminate this confusion, this kind of problems. Okay, if you want to impose anti-dumping duty, impose and declare how much. If you want to impose safeguard duty, impose, declare how much. For this, a month is enough. But keep on creating the dialogues and the debates coming on the media that India is going to impose duty, 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 when nothing is there. The Chinese has increased their price of panels. The Chinese say that Indian market is a main market for us. But unfortunately, if you keep on talking about the duty, our raw material cost also has gone high. So we will increase the price. So I clarified the government. There was a call from the Prime Minister's office. The principal secretary was asking me, Mr. Narasimhan, are you going to support the anti-dumping or going to oppose the anti-dumping? This was the question raised by the Prime Minister's office before our Honorable Prime Minister leaves to Devas. I told PM office, currently I am opposing. After the 3,000 megawatts which are on pipeline got cleared without any impact, then your proposal for anti-dumping or any safeguard duty, we want to support. We are all Indians. We need to go for a Make in India. Before going for a Make in India, we talked about 100 gigawatts. How to reach 100 gigawatts? You should have the manufacturing. Today we are having, everybody knows that, not even a 2 gigawatts, that is cell manufacturing, and 7 gigawatts of module manufacturing. That is also not functioning very well. So when you want, the government wants to support the manufacturing, come out with the clarifications. These are all the incentives for manufacturing in this country. Give subsidy
Today, Orissa government announced 25% of capital subsidy for module manufacturing. A company by name Topaz Energy today announced that they are going to set up a 500 megawatt of solar module and cell plant in Orissa. The same thing I asked our government, you announce some kind of incentives, manufacturing will come. Today, for all your information, the government of India manufacturing policy is under various kind of consultations and discussions. Shortly, they are going to announce a manufacturing policy. Our requirement is 20 gigawatt of module per annum. Our production is not even 2 to 3 gigawatt. Where can I go and get the modules for developing my project? This is the question raised by all the developers. We are not ignoring the local manufacturing. We want to strengthen the local manufacturing to the mega level. We want to support the developers, those who signed the PPAs, they should not get collapsed. So we want to combine both and equally to be treated. There should be a balanced system to support the manufacturing, to support the development developer. This we discussed already with the government of India. Tamil Nadu government, we are asking, give kind of support for manufacturing for module and cell. 20 gigawatt of manufacturing policy has been announced by government of India, where the first year 20 gigawatts, they are asking you to go for a module production, second year cell production, third year ingot and wafer production. This is under that confusion now. Where is the money? Where is the subsidy? Where is the technology to compete with Chinese, to compete with Korea, to compete with European? With that kind of situation, today our solar projects in crossroads. This is the present situation. But we people need not be panic. It is our elected government. Our grievances to be handled by them properly. Whichever the government, we want to represent the grievances properly, supporting the developer, supporting the mega manufacturing sector. At the end of the day, this entire delegation to pass kind of resolution in this way, there is no need for any duty imposition immediately on the projects whichever signed the PPAs. This voice should go from Tamil Nadu, this conference. At the same time, supporting for the manufacturers for all these segment, also we will support. At the end of the day, India is not going to be only a marketing country. India is going to be a manufacturing country under Make in India scheme. This is what we should keep in our mind. Today, this, tomorrow, manufacturing we want. Tamil Nadu, the government is planning to give you a good solution for creating a hub in Tirunelveli or Southern District for manufacturing of modules and cells. I know very well, Bosch also involved, all these companies are involved. Everyone will accept, we will go ahead on these policies and are putting our versions and our opinions. We'll pass a resolution at the end of the day to support government's vision. With this, any questions for our dais, most welcome. And again, I'm telling that solar is the future, where like your pension fund, where like your retirement funds, this keep on happening. Once you sign a PPA and establish your project, it is not for you. Next generation also, 25 years, it is going to give a fixed income. This is what I want to encourage solar projects. Not on the subsidy or not on the incentives like depreciation for 80%, 40%. That is all looked after by corporate sector. Let them do. For an ordinary man, 1 gigawatt, 5 gigawatt, 3 gigawatt, whatever, sorry, megawatt, whatever he wanted, let him set up the projects in Tamil Nadu. Net metering and the kind of rooftops, it is happening, it is going to happen. Otherwise, government of India, they won't be silent. They will push every state government. I want this much of solar rooftop from your state. Definitely, Tamil Nadu government has to install that. Coming to the storage on the energy part, we'll discuss later. Various technologies available for the energy storage. And we are all working with various institutions across the globe, either from Germany or China or kind of Japanese. Tesla, he was talking. That's not going to be a good solution. I was handling a big conference on the battery international in Stuttgart of Germany. I was meeting the people from Tokyo for another university. It is called Tokawu University. In this country, today we are talking with the Science and Technology Ministry. We are talking with a lot of technology people across the globe from Silicon Valley, Boston, Germany, Norway. All we are trying to unite to evolve a wonderful storage technology for India. Because our people always go for affordable technology at affordable cost. So with this kind of new evolution, this government already preparing a target that by 2030, there is no vehicle without the battery technology or storage system for the solar. So all there is another opportunity beyond solar for all of you. Try to come across investing into energy storage and a kind of electrical vehicle for going for a lithium-ion battery. People ask me, yesterday the NLC tender got scrapped because of storage facility was not viable cost. It's true. When Mahindra quoted, I talked to them, this cost of the storage technology, whatever you quoted, is it going to happen? Some kind of time we need, some kind of deployment of technology and R&D is required. Definitely India will emerge as the number one in this new battery, lithium ion battery technology. Many people not aware whether it is NAC or NMC or LFP or LM, various chemistries are involved in the technology. We are working out which is suitable for the charging station, which is suitable for the energy storage, which is suitable for the car, which is suitable for the lorry, which is suitable for the minivans, three-wheelers, two-wheelers. This is going to happen. So I would like to request all the entrepreneurs, those who gathered here, you try to come across investing into solar, investing into kind of battery technology, investing into energy storage. We will go ahead. There is a good scope and hope. I am not talking as a politician. I am talking as one among you. I know what is going to happen. So with this, all should have the clear mind. Out of that, your investment, I request all of you to come and invest in Tamil Nadu. This is only my request. With this, let me conclude the time being. If there is any question or answer, all we are here. We are prepared to answer you, any kind of confusions or any kind of doubts. Thank you.
Thank you so much. Thank you so much, sir, for your wise words here. So the process we are going to follow now is, since I am the moderator, I'll ask questions to specific panelists here. And then anyone is free to join or add to the answer once the answer has been given by the panelist. Obviously, I touched upon various topics that I wanted to ask in this forum. And after the first session is done, where the panelists have answered all the questions, then we'll open up the debate to the forum, and all of you can join in with your questions. First and foremost, since we are talking at a very broad level, my first question to Madam Geetha, if you can answer that. The roadmap for solar in Tamil Nadu coming financial year and the next one, let's say 1 or 2 years, what do you think are the kind of tenders that are going to come out? What will be the prospects for the developers as well as EPCs? And what kind of inclusiveness or the kind of tenders that you see coming, whether it is going to be big tenders, where it's going to be even for the smaller players enough to participate and, you know, get a share of the pie?
We already have a pipeline, some 1,500 megawatts already bidded, and sir has also participated the 3.47 thing. Apart from that, that is likely to get commissioned by 2019. Utility side, we are coming up with a EPC route, 500 megawatt solar power plant, and we'll be calling for tenders for doing it on EPC. It'll be owned by TNEB, and there will be one more, that reverse auction route tender for another 1,500 megawatt soon. Anybody with even 1 megawatt can still participate. It'll be a reverse auction type of thing. They have to acquire the land. Everything will be on that thing. They'll participate and. We will be procuring the power. And TNERC has come out, set up some purchase obligations also. That is now, I think it is 5%. So we are running short to meet the 5% today. So we will be open to have more participants, and we will be going with more installation. In another 2 years, we are sure we'll be crossing 5,000 megawatts in Tamil Nadu. Land as such, land acquisition is the problem even for our own project which is supposed to come. I think minister has agreed to do something, and we are looking for EPC contractors.
Well, let me tell you, ma'am, in my experience, I mean, Tamil Nadu is one of the better states when it comes to land. I mean, there are huge problems in other states. So that way, I think even if it's a land plus a tender, which is going to come out, I mean, this is one of the better states to work in from the developer's perspective.